फाइंड द स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 7. टू फाइंड द स्क्वायर रूट बाय लॉन्ग डिविजन मेथड, फॉर दैट फर्स्ट वी शुड फ्रेम इट इन दिस वे. सी दैट इज 7. Okay, next. Now here we have 7. 7 is not a perfect square. So now we should check between which two perfect square numbers does 7 lie. And the perfect square numbers are these. That is 2 into 2, 4. 3 into 3, 9. 4 into 4, 16, so on. These numbers are called perfect squares. Here we have 7. 7 lies between these two numbers. So we should take the smaller number, that is 4. 4 is 2 twos 4. So we take 2 twos 4. Now you should subtract. 7 minus 4 is 3. Okay. Here you should add these two numbers and write here. That is 2 plus 2. We get 4. Okay. Now I should write a number here. So when I write the number here, this number will become smaller than this. So in that case, in normal division, we used to put decimal and take 0 here. Over here, we should take 2 zeros. It is a rule. In normal division, only 1 zero. Here, we should take 2 zeros. Okay, now. Here, I should write a number. Condition is, whatever number I write here, here also I should write the same number. And also, when we multiply these two numbers, the resulting number should be equal to or smaller than this number, but not larger than this number. Okay. So let us find the number here. If we take 2, that is, we should also multiply by 2. So 2 into 2, 4, 2 fours, 8. 84 is far from 300. So if we take 4, we should also multiply by 4. 4 into 4, 16. 6, 1. 4 into 4, 16 plus 1, 7. 17. We get 176, also far. So we take 6. 6 into 6, 36. So 6, 3. 6, 4 is 24 plus 3, 27. So 276 is close to 300. So we take 6. So 6 here, 6 here, and here 276. Now you subtract. So here 2, here 9, 10. 10 minus 6, 4. 9 minus 7, 2. Here 2 minus 2, 0. Now here I should add these two numbers and write. 46 plus 6 is 52. Okay. Now I should write a number here. When I write the number, this number will be smaller than this number. We had already taken decimal, so here you directly take 2 zeros. In normal division, 1 zero, here we should take 2 zeros. Now, here we should write a number, and the condition is whatever number you write here, here also you should write the same number. And also, when you multiply this number and this number, the resulting number should be smaller or equal to this number. but not larger than this number.
Okay.
So let us find the number here. If we take 4, so 524, we should also multiply by 4. So 4 into 4, 16, 6, 1, 4, 2, 8, plus 1, 9, 4, 5 is 20. We get 2096. If we take 5, we should also multiply by 5. 5 into 5, 25, 5, 2. 5, 2 is 10, plus 2, 12. So 2, 1. 5, 5 is 25, plus 1, 26. This is larger than this. So we should take 2096 for the number 4. So here 4, here 4, and here 2096. Now you subtract. So here 3, 9, 10. Here you get 4, here 0. 3 minus 0 is 3, 2 minus 2 is 0. Here we should add these two numbers and write. 524 plus 4 is 528.
Okay.
Now I should write a number here. When I write the number, then this number will become smaller than this. We already have a decimal, so you directly take two zeros. In normal division, one zero, here two zeros. Now, here we should write a number. Condition is, whatever number we write here, here also the same number. And also, when we multiply this number and this number, the resulting number should be smaller or equal to this, but not larger than this. So let us find the number here. So if we take 5, that is 5285, we should also multiply by 5. 5 into 5, 25. So 52. 58 is 40 plus 2, 42. 24. 52 is 10 plus 4, 14. 41. 55 is 25 plus 1, 26. We got 26,000. If we take 6, 5286 into 6. 6 into 6, 36. 6 8 is 48 plus 1 plus 3, 51. So 1 here, 5 here. 6 2 is 12 plus 5, 17. So 7 here, 1 here. 6 5 is 30 plus 1, 31. So when we take 6, it's exceeding this number. So we take 5. So 5 here, 5 here, and here 2 6, 4 2 5. Now you subtract and it goes on. It is enough if you do up to 3 decimal places. And the square root of 7 is this one, 2.645, and goes on. This is our answer. Am I clear?